so bad.
Met nobody telling you no cute. Met nobody telling you no nice. Cause you the star girl in my world. You the star girl in my life, man. Guys, this is like my first video that I'm actually uploading in a very long time. Because my other video that I uploaded is actually a very old video, so I haven't been in front of like a camera doing YouTube in a very long time. Anyway, I'm not gonna talk too long. If you notice anything different about me, guys, I got my braces removed. I still haven't finished treatment, so I even have an appointment in like a week's time, so I have to go back to London. And yes, for those wondering, I started uni, started my new uni, so that's why I'm in a different setting right now. Like a lot of new things are really happening for me this year, like a big change and stuff like that. Obviously, I've been trying to work on my mental health. I've been doing a social media detox, so I haven't been on social media like that. In a while anyway, so I deleted Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram. Not really on Instagram like that, same with my TikTok. So yeah, that's what I've been doing anyway. I should have uploaded this video at least like a year and a bit. I think I should have uploaded this video back in 2021. Yes, I should have uploaded this video back in 2021. I'm only uploading it now, so I really apologize. But anyway guys, we're just going to start the video. I'm basically going to break it down into chunks, talking about my experience and then giving you guys tips. I wouldn't have done it without the support of my people them. So I did ask a few people to give me a few tips, because on the day I actually knew a lot of people that actually went, but I didn't get to see them just due to like, obviously some people I didn't know that were going until like the actual day. And also the fact that it was too packed, service was really bad. I'm gonna do a vlog video on my experience with uni, and I already did my vlog for that, so that will be coming up soon, hopefully, fingers crossed. I have a lot of YouTube videos and I've edited them and everything, but I like to upload my videos in order, if that makes sense. Like I don't want to upload a video that I created in 2023 and then I haven't uploaded the ones in 2021 yet, hence why it takes me long to upload them. I don't have OCD a bit, where it's like I like things done in a certain order, in a certain way. So that's why it takes me long to upload videos, because I'm like, okay, cool, there's some things I need to... Anyway, whatever. If you get it, you get what I mean. So yeah, we're going to start the video.
I'm kind of full. This shit started at... Well, this is started at 11 a.m. And right now it's basically 1 p.m. Well, the earliest eyes I wanted to see perform starts at 2:20 p.m. So there's no way I'm going to make it like an hour and 20 minutes, keeping in mind the queue and lining up and all the checks that they have to do before entry. But anyway, and I meant to meet some people. But yeah, so yeah, I can't really talk too much, guys. But I'm going to see you soon. And I don't want my battery to die and get low, but the way it's looking, yes. But I'm going to try to vlog what I can. You feel me? All right, cool, guys.
Bro, why is the train so packed?
I just want my friend to my friend. And apparently the line is so cute today. So, I mean, the line is so long to the extent where she can't even see the entrance. And like the queue goes all the way around the park. So I don't even know. Bro, bro.
Yo guys, obviously I'm here walking and they're playing Mr. Banks. I literally missed it, guys. So I'm here vibing to the music from outside. Came here looking like a star. Yo bruh, I've actually missed it. I actually missed Mr. Banks before. Anyway. Guys, the queue is mad long, bruh. Seeing it there. Why am I seeing it all the way? Look, I see she going all the way down there. fuck. I think the queue goes down there. Yo. Yo, guys.
Yeah. Yeah. To the streets, because everyone that came just ruined my experience a little bit. No, not a little bit, actually. A lot of people were very arrogant, but anyway, we moved.
A lot of them really were.
Yeah, a lot of pushing and shit. Would you say it's worth your money though?
Yeah.
No, but the capacity was too much. They actually should have reduced it.
They should have done like two separate days or something.
Yeah. Or at least make it sold out. At least when you want to meet, make sure. Yeah.
Yeah, you can pay at the door.
Yeah, literally. Fuck's sake. Who can admire you? Are we still in see this shit? She got the right place.
In 1 minute. Are you vlogging?
Yep. Manda's YouTube. Yeah. Too packed, man, for my liking. Yo.
Yeah, I'm gonna talk about my experience in Yam. So obviously, before we arrived, they made us do like a COVID test. So we had to do a COVID test before entering. which wasn't really ideal because not a lot of people had the COVID sticks. Yes, guys, this was during COVID times. So, you know, everyone had the COVID sticks. So, cool. I had a lot because when I did my placement that year, they gave us like a box of them anyway. Also, my mum works within the NHS, so she gets a lot of them too. And also, my brother was getting a lot from his school. I don't think they were even checking like that. They checked mine, but the amount of people that were there, it was just crazy. So, I enter, cool. I don't know where my people them are. I didn't know there was going to be bad service. If I knew, I would have probably met my friends beforehand or met them before entering. But anyway, I eventually met one of the girls because I was meant to be my friend and her friend. I met her friend. And this was a girl that I was going on holiday with as well, like literally a few weeks after that. So cool. You know, it was calm and all, but it was too packed for my liking. I missed a few artists. I went to meet one of my friends, Karika. Shout out to Karika. But I didn't get to even see her on a day. So it was just like, I just couldn't meet my friends. Like, I just couldn't see my friends. So cool. I went there. Girls were screwing. Girls were just looking at you. Keeping in mind, yeah, that day I wore a lace wig. That was my first time wearing a lace wig. And that day, it wasn't really coming to bar. And you see me, when it comes with lace wigs, I get a bit iffy because I'm just like, bruh, are they looking at my lace? You're like, are they looking at my lace? You know, you're having girls looking at you, especially when they're looking at your hair. And you're just like really conscious. And you're like, oh my gosh, like they're looking at my lace, they're looking at my lace. And I don't know, like, cool. The lines for the food, by far, too long, way too long. Luckily, I actually wasn't really hungry like that from what I remember, so I wasn't even gonna buy anything anyway. They had three different stages. They had the main stage and then they have other two stages. I forgot what they were called. They put the bigger artists obviously on the main stage and like more of like, I don't want to say smaller artists, but they put some of like the, you know, average, whatever you want to call them, just put a few more artists on the other stage. And then there was the other stage. I didn't go to that one because any of the artists that were performing in that one, I didn't know them anyway. They gave us a list of all the artists that were going to perform and the times. Okay, me and the girls arranged prior the times that we basically organized it. So what time we're gonna see what artist and stuff like that. And it's good to discuss with your friends beforehand, so everyone talks about what artists they wanna see and what time, so that way it's not clashing, because a lot of the artists were clashing. So say you wanted to see like an artist at like, I don't know, 2:30 and another one was gonna perform at like 2:35. It kind of clashes, especially with, like, obviously them being in different stages as well. So I feel like it's a discussion that you should have with your friends anyway beforehand. The only reason really why I went to YAM was to see Kalani and Coffee. I can't lie to you. Usually concerts are not really my type of setting, just because of the fact that I'm really short and I ain't gonna see shit anyway. Do you know what I mean? But obviously I was like, cool, let's go for the vibes. Me and my friend booked it time ago anyway. I don't know, it was just too much for me. I just couldn't see shit at all. I couldn't see shit. Way too packed for my liking. You're constantly losing your friends, so that's another thing. Like, hold on tight to your friends, because like, you may potentially lose them, so just keep that in mind. Obviously when it came to Coffee, I wasn't playing around when it came to Coffee. Do you know what I mean? Obviously at the time, guys, I've met Coffee before, so I'm really guessed about that. I'll do a separate YouTube video about that, like, so stay tuned for that. My girl crush, like, Coffee has my heart, and I said, oh, she's so sweet in real life, like, she's such a sweetheart. And she's really attractive, like, she's really attractive. So yeah, at the time, obviously, this was years before, so I hadn't met Coffee then, but that was my first time seeing Coffee in, like, flesh. So I wasn't playing about, because everyone that knows me knows I love Coffee. So when it came to now her time to perform, it was packed. Keeping in mind, yeah, I set a time on my phone like for 15 minutes before the time she was supposed to start. Even before, it was still packed. So I met this girl with the pink hair. She was just bare holding my hand. She was like, babe, let's go, let's go. Like, she was drunk. You could tell she was drunk based off her vibes and her energy. But she's lit. And she was just holding my hand. And I left my friend. I could just see them just drowning in the crowd. Like, they were just gone. And I could just feel holding each other as well, because I was holding the girl and then I was holding my friends. So our hands, like, just let go. Like, we just partied away. Cool. So with the coffee thing, it was way too heated. I didn't even know coffee got that much recognition like that. Yam was in South London that year, so I didn't know, like, bare people were feeling her like that. But I was like, all right, there. So cool. I'm having people touching me and stuff like that. I had a guy grab my bum. Yes, I had a guy grab my bum. I don't even know. Then I had one chap just come to me, and he was like, obviously this guy was like 6'7" basically, and he was like, oh, do you want me to like lift you up so you can see? And then I was like, I bet. But then he was like, it was for £20, for £20. And I was like, £20? And he's like, yeah. And I was like, but I'm cute, you know, the ones. I was like, but I'm cute. And then he was like, yeah, sweetheart, but like, your cuteness ain't gonna pay my bills, you know what I mean? So I was like, forget. So I just kept pushing and shoving, because like I said, I wasn't playing when it came to coffee. With the other artists, I was like, babe, if I can't see, I can't see, you know what I mean? I wasn't gonna force it. And the chances of me getting to the front were like unlikely anyway, because it was bare packed and I was like all the way at the back. It's one of those things where when you leave the crowd, you can't get back in. Like, just forget about it. You can't get back in. So it's a bit peak as well when you want to see artists in other stages and you're on the main stage and you actually have a good view, but now you have to leave. And even is a struggle. 60% of her performance I couldn't see. I had people offering. That's why you could see sometimes I got a good show. I had other people offering to like use my thing to like record. It's just jarring. Cool. At this point, the girl in the pink hair, I think I don't know what happened to her. I have no memory of it. I remember I came across these girls. They were just looking at me up and down, like, what are you doing? And then I was like, I want to see. Like, what the fuck? So I just kept pushing and pushing again, just kept pushing. Still couldn't see. It's now like halfway to her performance. I'm somewhat near the front. And I'm like, okay, cool. Like, I'm like, this is better because I can like, now at least see at this point. But at most time, I'm seeing through the gaps of people. Do you know what I mean? Which is a bit sad. But I could see now. I could physically see coffee. And I was just like, oh my God. Like, I was like, oh my God.
Also, guys, you know, I had a guy that could actually acknowledge that I was short. And he was like, oh, do you want to go to the front? So pick up the people then, yeah, that actually see short people and allow them in the front. Because some people are just...
If there's a short person near you and you know you're actually of average height or tall, the smart thing is to let them go in front of you anyway, because you can it's not gonna affect you. You can still see. Do you know what I mean? So I appreciate that people actually have common sense to allow people that are shorter than them to go in front of them.
I can't even emphasize the amount of times I lost the girls. I can't emphasize how many times I lost them, way too many times to count. Like, I at least lost them a good 5 times. I don't even know how I ended up finding them. It got to a point where sometimes I was speaking to one of like the male staff, never really friendly, by the way, so shout out to them. And they were like, oh, try go on this sport, maybe you can get good service. I'm just like, you know, making comfort. But oh, I told my thought, never again that day, never again, never again. Cool. Obviously, with Kalani, her set was just not working, and it was just not it at all. I wasn't feeling it, to be honest. Like I said, I only came for 2 artists.
The journey going back home after a concert is like the worst thing, and I dread it every time. It's generally the worst thing because now everyone is rushing to go home. Getting cab is almost impossible. I actually end up actually getting a cab, but then at this point, me and my friends, we all went to McDonald's, and the queue was just like ridiculous.
Will it? Instagram.
I got my order, then the cab driver was calling me like, where are you? And I was like, yeah, I'm coming, I'm sorry, like, it's just a long queue. Cool, I get my food now. I'm seeing now the cab is cancelled. So I'm just like, cool, I'm trying to order a new one. At this point, they now say all cabs are not working around this area. And I'm just like, are you kidding me? Like, I actually got a cab. And they took my money too. I think they took my money. Yeah, they took my money. And then, like, days later, the cab company called me and said,
we really apologise that this cab driver acted this way or whatever. We're going to compensate? I can't say that word. We're going to reimburse you. No, we're going to give your money back. Cool. I'm like, thank you. It's fine. They were like, okay, we're going to stop this cab driver from working with you ever again. We really do apologise.
So I'm here walking outside with my feet. So imagine I have my McDonald's feet. And obviously, the whole street is packed. I even put it, you could see in the video that it was packed. I don't know why I'm holding it like this. A girl comes rushing into my drink and everything just pours. So I'm just standing there looking at her and she turns back and she's like, oh, sorry. And then she keeps walking and I'm just like, bro, you don't even understand the time that I waited, yeah, the money that went into that. So you don't understand the struggle it was for me to get that meal. And drinks at McDonald's are not cheap, do you know what I mean? Especially when like it's a meal and stuff. It's not cheap. That's an extra £2 basically added on top of that just for you to bash into my drink and everything scatters, as you can see in the clip. At this point, I was fed up for the day. I just wanted to go home. Keeping in mind now, at this time, it's 1 a.m. in the morning. I was in Canterbury the day before. Yeah, cool. How are we actually going to get home? Because it's 1 a.m. Train station ain't really open like that. But anyway, we ended up figuring out. We took a bus to the nearest station that was open. And then, yeah, then I got a train home from Central London. Because it's easier getting a train from Central London anyway for me personally. Because I don't live too far in terms of trains and stuff. Artists were not too bad. Fortunately, I missed Midasa Jagaban. Saw Coffee, so that was good. Saw Kalani perform, although she didn't really perform songs that I know like that. And I tend to know all of Kalani's songs. Like, she didn't sing her main songs. I don't know if that's due to Yam just messing everything up for her. Davido, they messed it up too for him. So Dark could perform, but Dark is not really like I've met Dark in real life and she seems like a nice girl anyway, and we've DM'd each other before. Don't really think anything of Dark like that. She's just a normal girl, plus she's really local. Like, she really is based local to me because her best friends went to the same school as me, and have them on Snap as well. Literally, she's a local girl, but big up to her anyway. She's really doing well for music, so. And I love Darko's music, so. and then, oh yeah, NSG performed. English. NSG performed, so that was okay. I'm surprised I didn't have to go to the toilet that day. I'm glad I didn't go to the toilet. I can't believe, because I really do, because I really want. I actually never used the toilet, not once. And also, I'm surprised that my friend didn't die like that. I don't know, anyway. But yeah, that was really briefly my experience of Yam. I really don't recommend it, but yeah. Like, literally, you're just better off watching performances on YouTube. Like, for example, I've seen Wireless. Wireless. This last year's Wireless looked mad. Okay, it's just crazy. These things, yeah, are just not it. It's just not it. know, especially the thing, what do we call it, when people just start bushing into each other. Anyway, guys. So guys, I'm just gonna read out the things that my friends have said and their experience of YAM. You guys can hear as well other people's feedback of YAM and their tips on how you should prepare for these things. I would say you're just better off watching it on Snapchat, people's socials, Twitter, YouTube, than going there in real life, because at least with YouTube, at least you get a good view, you know what I mean? So this was maybe like a one-time thing. I don't think I'd really go again. I don't like concerts and stuff. It takes me a lot to go to them. So anyway, I've got my laptop and I'm gonna read them out anyway. So let me see. I feel like they put some of the artists that they put on different stages just didn't make sense. Or some artists that should have been put on the main stage. Like a lot of people say that Coffee should have been put on the main stage, because when it came to her performing in the middle stage, whatever it was called, let's just call it that for now, it was just too packed and stuff like that. So I'll put videos or videos that I've seen other people post and stuff like that, but it was just crazy. But Coffee's a big artist, so I don't know why she was in the other stage. I believe they even put Yemi Alade in that stage too. I didn't get to see her perform though, unfortunately. Rima didn't even show up. Everyone was just pissed, and apparently he went to go perform somewhere else. Yeah, he went to go perform at one of my concerts, the other concert that one of my friend works, because my friend works at like organizing concerts and stuff like that. So I think Rima ended up performing at where she works. So I don't know, he just ditched, yeah, he just didn't even show up. With Coffee, she was meant to apparently attend Lick, because Lick was on the same day as YAM. I've been to Lick before, but I didn't go to that one. Lick is basically you know what, go Google it. Apparently Coffee didn't end up showing up anyway, just due to maybe how people would perceive it if she performed in that type of setting. So yeah, that was that anyway. So Coffee didn't end up, I didn't even know they booked Coffee to perform at Lick. If I knew, I would have gone. My friend Karika went anyway, so I don't know. People even have speculations that Kalani would perform, but Kalani said no, she wouldn't. She didn't know about Lick, and she wasn't gonna be a guest star. So I don't know. Yeah, speakers were trash about me, and some people said, "Oh my god, I've been saying this to everyone." When it came to Coffee, the people that were at the front didn't even know the words. That was what was pissing me off, and I was here. Just lit. Ugh. When it comes to me, I know all of Coffee's songs. I know every single one of Coffee's songs that she's put out there, even the songs that she's featured in. Even if she had like two words to say in a song, I know that song. I'll guarantee you, I know that song. But I don't play when it comes to Coffee, do you know what I mean? That's my everything. Let the people that know the words go in the front, do you know what I mean? Like, there'll just be people just standing there like this while she's singing. I'm just here like, you're pissing me off. Because I've been to a lot of Coffee's performances before, and I'm vibing, I'm singing her songs word to word. Like, I'm not even playing. Kalani's set was cut after waiting 40 minutes, apparently. Okay, so we had to wait a long time for Kalani to perform, and her set was cut, apparently. So, I don't know, I wasn't even paying attention too much. I do know that it took time for her to perform, and there was some issues that was going on with her performance, and it was, yeah, she didn't get to perform a lot of songs and stuff, and she was saying how that YAM kind of will owe us like a performance, because this was just not it. And obviously she was going to an after party that day, so she was telling everybody if anyone wanted to go to her after party, they could pull up. Because I know she does that a lot. Every time she comes to London to perform, a lot of the time she's always having after parties. Like, you've seen them on TikTok and stuff like that. Yeah, people are like, oh, they couldn't even enjoy it properly because of how long we were anticipating her performance and how quickly it got cut off. David actually tried with what he had, to be honest. Like, he definitely lifted up the spirits of the Kalani. Yeah, you could see in the videos what he really tried, because I was looking back at the video and I'm like, wait, what's going on? Like, there was no music and he was still going. the crowd did not pass the vibe check. Okay, that's what someone said to me. That's what one of my friends said. Okay, one of my friends said that the list of the set list was us. Some artists on other stages should have been on the main stage, or at least not at the same time as the other artists. So yeah, I agree. That's what I said before as well. Customer care did not exist. Bare artists dropped out until last minute. Some of them which were not notified, or some artists couldn't even perform. Okay. Someone said, I did not expect fireworks debris to be on me. Never again. Okay, someone had some kind of fireworks debris. I don't know how to say that word, but yeah. I didn't know how I was gonna get home, I can't lie. One of my friends had actually got a hotel, and this is another friend, but I never met her. Yeah, I'm like, I didn't get to see her that day, unfortunately. And we had planned previously to like at least come across each other to say hi, because we're from the same country as well. And she ordered a hotel with her friend. My friend ordered a hotel, and she was like, oh, you can come and stay with us and stuff like that. But I was like, it's fine anyway. The girls that I was with, they live in a different part of London to me. They live in northwest London, I live in southeast London. Amsterdam Carnival was hella long journey. Time change, so make sure you check before and just arrive before you depart to go Yamkani. Secondly, I would say bring drinks with you, as security allows you to bring drinks. Okay, I didn't know that. I personally don't drink. Thirdly, have a timetable of the artists you want to see on your phone, so you know the exact times you have to be moved in stages, because there's three. Lastly, bring vibes to the event, because you never know, you might be meeting a gang of people you're going to spend the day with if your friend is late. Fair enough. Come somewhat early. The festival setups are usually weird. Bring your own food. The queues were like a mile long. It's true, they were really a mile long. Save your money. Watch it from YouTube or something. Definitely. Look at the journey going and returning. I generally feel like I was going to sleep on the streets that night. Requested over 5 different cabs from different places, in which they all cancelled. Put into consideration, queues may be long. Also, they do check your bags before you enter, so please be sensible. I think they check your bags, if I'm pretty sure. Or they just do a quick check. I'm not too sure. I can't remember. People will screw you, so prepare that, because a lot of the time people scream, it happens. Yeah, and wear like correct shoes, please. You don't want to wear expensive shoes and then people are treading on them, stepping on them in the shade. Like, eat very well before, like a full English breakfast or something, because if you make it to the front at a festival, you ain't ever coming back if you leave. Bring water, but only drink it in a small intervals throughout the day. Saves you from having to go to the toilet. Don't buy from the food places that were really disappointing, because I'm assuming that food was expensive anyway, so they always are. They really are, especially when they say that you can't bring in your own food to the festival, because they want to encourage people to buy from the actual place. But I'm pretty sure something like a hot dog and chips will probably be like £5, £6. Like, it's ridiculous. Or probably £8. A can of drink could probably be like £2. That's just an example anyway, so I don't know the actual prices, but it differs because there were different food stations. But that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you guys in my next video. I know God has amazing good things installed for me this year, and I knew it was to him. Everything will work out for me. But yeah, guys, this is just the beginning. So yeah, and I'm grateful for that. No, let nobody tell you you're not cute. No, let nobody tell you you're not nice. No, 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 no.